Adventure is out there!
Cross your heart! Cross it! Okay, well, we'll take these off. Only a little bit.
Now the theatrics are over. Okay.
So, today we're going to be talking about finding the gospel in Up!
Love this movie.
So good. We all know that a major theme in the movie is Carl, Mr. Fredrickson, trying to get to Paradise Falls.
Yeah, Paradise Falls was the goal for him and his wife their entire life because adventure is out there, and that was the destination for the spirit of adventure.
After Ellie dies, Carl makes it his life mission to get to Paradise Falls for the both of them. And he goes through a lot to get there. He turns his house into a literal hot air balloon, goes through this crazy storm, ends up with a kid. Russell happens to be there too. He literally carries his house on his back and trying to get to Paradise Falls.
Mm-hmm.
Gets attacked by dogs.
Is almost killed multiple times.
Charles Munns, he's crazy. Yeah. Anyway, and he finally gets to Paradise Falls. And it's a little bit of a letdown.
Yeah.
It wasn't what he thought it was going to be. It wasn't this huge climactic moment that he had been wanting this whole time.
Yeah, reaching the top of that mountain, being next to the waterfall, wasn't the pinnacle of his life. Yeah. That was actually just a turning point for him to realize that he was missing the point, that he was missing the mark. And luckily, he had the adventure book. Luckily, he had Ellie's My Adventure book with him. So when he opened that, he realized they had a full adventure together and that he's still on an adventure. It's not over for him. He's still going, and that reaching a destination isn't an adventure. The adventure is the journey. And so he then realized that he'd been missing the point the whole time. When Mr. Fredrickson was up there on the top of that mountain in his house all alone, he came to realize he was missing the mark. And in the Book of Mormon, Jacob chapter 4, verse 14, it talks about missing the mark, the thing that's right in front of you. Talking about the Jews, they despised the words of plainness and killed the prophets, and sought for things that they could not understand. Wherefore, because of their blindness, which blindness came by looking beyond the mark, they must needs fall. For God hath taken away his plainness from them, and delivered unto them many things that they cannot understand, because they desired it. And because they desired it, God hath done it, that they may stumble. So at that point, Carl realized that he was missing the mark. He attained this thing that was beyond, like, their wildest dreams, their ultimate goal. But the things that were right in front of him and most important, he was missing. And we can see that throughout the entire movie, looking back from that point.
Yeah. Yeah, because at the beginning of the movie, right when Carl's lifting off in his house, they come upon this storm, and all of his possessions start to fall all over the place in his house. The pictures start to fall, and he's rushing from one end of the house to the other to try to catch everything and save all of his stuff. At the end of the movie, we see how much his focus and his direction has changed, because when Russell decides to head out, Carl realizes, oh no, I want to be with him. I want to help him. I want him in my life. And he starts to chuck all of his stuff out of his house. He throws it all out And he literally like relieves himself of the weight of what he thought he wanted that has actually been holding him back the whole time.
Little Rodrigo. Russell. Little Russell definitely needed Carl, Mr. Fredrickson, in his life to be that father figure.
Yeah. And obviously we'd seen the movie before, but I'd kind of forgotten about all the other themes that are like Paradise Falls in it for all the other characters. Because Russell thinks that he just wants his badge of assisting the elderly, but it was actually so much more than that. He wanted connection with a father figure. And Doug thought that he wanted to take this bird captive and have him as a prisoner for his master, but that's not what he actually wanted.
Yeah, he wanted recognition and someone to love him.
Right.
He thought that bringing back Kevin the bird would bring him that, but he found that there was someone out there, Mr. Fredrickson, that once he came around, he would just give him that love and attention that he needed.
Right. Even Charles Munns, the scary guy in the movie, he said that he wanted to bring this bird back to be able to prove himself, but it was actually about his image. It was about pride. It was about him being embarrassed and wanting to prove himself to people. Anyway, there's just all of these things that we think that we want. And as we're all working so hard toward this thing we want, a lot of times we miss the mark of what Heavenly Father knows that we actually need. Along the way to Paradise Falls, Russell talks with Carl about his dad, and he starts to name off some seemingly mundane things of counting cars and the ice cream that they had. Russell kind of catches himself as he's talking about these things and looking back really fondly on them. And he seems almost a little bit embarrassed. And he says, "That may sound boring, but I think it's the boring stuff that I remember the most." Mm-hmm. And that got me.
Yeah.
Especially at this time when we're all home right now. And
we're in the COVID-19 era.
Yeah, there's not much that we can do, not much to entertain ourselves with except being together. And that may seem like the boring stuff, but that is the stuff that our children, that we will remember most.
Yeah. One of the things that I remember most from my childhood is holding every single night without fail, we had scripture study and prayer as a family. And yeah, it was kind of boring, especially as a kid, but that's one of my fondest memories, is being able to share together the Word of God. And that consistent, boring activity really has become such a fond and important memory to me and has shaped who I am. So during this current time of the COVID-19, we're all staying inside, and it feels like this really long time where we're all quarantined. But if we look to the beginning of the movie, where they go through the entirety of Carl and Ellie's life together in such a quick amount of time, honestly, we all like in those like 5 minutes, we cry. We feel it, because that's how life goes. Life goes by so quickly, and it's just such a short little period of time for us. And that's honestly what it is for us in the grand scheme of things, in God's plan of salvation. We have this short little time here to love each other, to serve each other, to come to know God better. And it honestly helps us grow so much, and is such a fond memory. So much so that looking back over it really quickly can bring us to tears. And they're tears of joy and understanding of life's purpose. So,
Vic is crying. The movie's still too fresh to do this. first 5 minute or so montage that we see Carl and Ellie's life together, we do start to get a feel for how short this mortal experience really is. And especially in the grand scheme of things, because we have eternal life to go.
That adventure will continue for eternity. That's why it's called eternal life. And being able to love each other, serve each other, and grow together, that's what eternal life is ultimately in the grand scheme of things. It's growing closer to God and growing closer to our brothers and sisters, everyone here on earth together. So trying to get better, trying to grow and progress throughout all eternities, because Jesus Christ has enabled it to be so. Okay. So what we learn from this movie is that mortality teaches us about immortality and eternal life. The end of the movie, the house is floating down and away, out of sight, and it's gone. And Carl says, it's just a house. But symbolically, it ends up right at the top of Paradise Falls, where the life that Carl and Ellie built together, that was the goal and the destination. But when Carl was there earlier, he felt empty and like incomplete. And the reason is because eternal life isn't eternal life without those that we love and without the opportunity to help others grow and the opportunity for others to help us grow. Eternal life is living how God lives and how God would have us live, which is loving each other and serving each other. And so from that point forward, when Carl throws everything out of the house and floats off to go be a tutor and a mentor to Russell, that's eternal life. That's being able to grow and progress and move up. And that's why this movie is probably called Up, is because that's the direction we're all growing, and that's the direction we're all moving towards together. We are all together moving towards eternal life as we love each other, serve each other, and serve God.
And that's how we found the gospel in Up. I will try to be less emotional next time.
And until then, go do something awesome for someone else, because guess what? Adventure is out there!